Hey everybody, welcome back to Wasteland 2. This is starting to get kind of interesting. We've got a lot of different stories that I feel are going to kind of overlap in one way or the other. We might screw it up somehow. We're looking for this farmer named Jess who doesn't happen to be in the area, but we've got all these locked doors. And I'm going to try getting into these. We shouldn't have too much of a problem since we've got these maxed out. I'm just really hoping that the people around us don't freak out and then send everybody towards us. Okay, this is probably bad. Dried blood splatters of Tabor's otherwise spotless surface. There's an open letter stuck to the blood. Can we somehow get that off of there? Can we surgeon it off, maybe? Sounds really silly, but I have no idea. Buzzing of flies is louder. Seems to be coming from the other side of the kitchen table. Little girl did not die from violence. It looks like she was sick. Two people and a baby lie on her floor. The woman holds the baby in her arms. Where's this at? Oh, it's all still here. Okay. The man holds the woman. It looks like a family portrait, except the bullet holes in the heads of the man and the woman. The man had a pistol. Also, they just ended it. It got that bad. Hello. This is, I think, the same energy weapon that we currently have. Pulse rifle. It is. I feel like there's something with this table, but I can't really... There's nothing we can do for it. Very weird. Hey, someone's alive. Hogarth. Red 9 on black 10. Gambling addict. These cards can predict the future. They're telling me I can never win. Just a little crashy poo. Okay. There's nothing going on in here, though. This is really weird. Looks like it could fall apart at any minute. Bits of scrap lumber are all that stop the roof from caving in. Cantilever. And a dead person. Looks like Kelly's just hot to touch. Doesn't wake when you shake her. I'd like to be alone with my wife. Is there anything we can do? I don't think so. Well, maybe. Okay. She's coughing. We may have temporarily helped her, I guess, but... Other than that, not much going on in there. Okay, very strange. Perhaps just further incentive to find this cure. But for that, we need the microscope in the other place. What's going on here now? Some fool tried to take my... Tried to rob the bank? Got away with a handful of... Oh, and we just took them. Okay, so this is the bank. Who Sandy blasted? Nobody, really. So we got bank guards. Oh my god. few jerks guard the front half of the bank. The back half is behind a teller cage made of chicken wire and an old mahogany bar. A locked door at one end of the bar lets authorized personnel into the cage. At a window, a teller waits, and behind her you see the bank president's office and a massive iron safe, half sunk into the shattered floor and wide open. Who's this? Oh, that's Mr. Gecko. Got a locked door here. Lock and an alarm there. This jerk is dangerously bored. A prim woman in an office patched, often patched pantsuit. She looks more proper than helpful. Would you like to make a deposit, a withdrawal, or exchange currency? I'd like to make a deposit. Certainly, what's your account number? I don't have one. Ah, you have to talk to our president, Mr. Gecko. He opens all new accounts personally. Shall I call him? Not now. But that's actually cool, because that's a good way to get in. We can't make a withdrawal, because we don't have an account. Which would take us to him as well. But let's see if we exchange. A bit short in cash, can only fit coins into bullets, not the other way around. Have a look at our rates. Okay, so we could buy this, but we don't really need to do any of this. Alright, so let's set up an account then. Yes, Lizzie? These folks would like to open an account. Very good, send them in. Mr. Gecko will see you now. Have a nice day. Oh, look at this. Look at that. We have a way in. We have another way in. That gotta lead somewhere. We're gonna have to find that. Mr. Gecko, I'm Morton Gecko. Welcome to the Bank of Cordite. I understand you well-armed folks would like to open an account and secure your ammo. Well, I don't know if we'd like to secure our ammo. Tell us about this bank. Certainly, the Bank of Cordite is a trusted institution that's helping Rhodia get back on its feet. Not only do we have the strongest safe in the LA wetlands, we also offer exchange services for all account holders. Have a grenade, but need some 308? No problem. Our tellers are happy to oblige. Okay, you think Rhodia will get back on its feet? Of course it will. The jewel of the wetlands, our humble township. It is a marvel to watch civilization reconstitute itself before our very eyes. And I thank my stars that the leather jerks have consented to help us protect it. Certainly more than our mayor ever did. You don't like the mayor. Well, our dearly departed mayor was a good man and a good friend, but a terrible mayor. Dearly departed. He's departed by now, isn't he? He's been up in that radio tower for days. He wants him to die. There's radio equipment in the tower stronghold, but it hasn't worked for years. The only thing more durable and reliable than our famous towers is the full faith and credit of the Bank of Cordite. So you approve of these guys, obviously. I do. That Oakwing mayor brought them in as a security consultant when the synths showed up, but seeing the terrible state of the place when they arrived, the sickness to name but one woe, they decided a complete regime change was in order. And I, for one, welcome our new leather jerk overlords. Mr. O'Biggin and Mr. Dangler are just the visionaries that this town needs. So Dangler, he thinks Mr. O'Biggin's advisor? A man of vision and very persuasive in his arguments. I must say, I hardly approve of his plans for this bank. I mean, this town. What about O'Biggin? He's a somewhat eccentric individual, I admit, but he seems to rule the leather jerks with a firm hand. I have every confidence in his leadership. What's the sickness, Mr. Gecko? I don't know what it is, but it's been a terrible depletion of the labor pool. I hope Dr. Horshada can get it under control quickly. He came to Rhodia a while ago, another sign that we are the city of the future. Cheap, abundant medical care is another example of why we're the jewel of the wasteland. Tell us about these synths. Metalmen from the south. Very disagreeable, but the jerks made short work of them, and now we are safe. Is your safe safe? Indeed it is. In addition to the guards, the rope you see means that I or the tellers can close and lock the safe anytime we feel alarmed. And the time lock mechanism renders it unopenable for 12 hours. This gives everyone in the town time to mobilize and defend their ammunition. I assure you, your ammunition is safe with us. The rope you see. Okay. Didn't we just see a robbery here? Oh, that's hardly a robbery. Desmond Mann grabbed a handful of loose bullets from the teller and made a run for it. The leather jerk stopped him and sad, yet effective demonstration of our security. You don't have any cat litter, do you? Why would a bank have cat litter? Such a silly question. Well, I'd like to open an account. Excellent. I'll write down your details and inform our teller. When you're ready, just deposit currency of any kind with her and you're all set. I do want to remind you, however, that we only pay out withdrawals in bullets, which are the only legal tender in Rhodia. So use bullets as money. Yeah, Rhodia recently changed the bullet standard. The value of scrap was fluctuating too much to make it a stable currency, but bullets are always highly valued. Plus, it's a boon for public safety. When a man has to get his bullets out of the bank, he thinks twice about gunning his wife down. Okay. I'm not seeing this rope. But, oh man, do we need to get back there. We'll find a way in. But, we have alarms. We do have alarms. But that sewer entrance gives me hope. Would you like to make a deposit or withdrawal? Let's deposit. Just so we have something in here. Let's just drop in like one thing. No, we're good. Now if I want a withdrawal, please 3-day hold, are you high? I'm sorry I didn't make the rules, but if you'd like an exception to our policy, you can talk to our president, Morton Gecko. Okay. Gecko. Your teller says there's a 3-day hold before we can withdraw our bullets. We need them now. Well, it's our stated policy, but I'll see what I can do. Give me a few hours to look into it, then come back. I'm sure we can sort it all out. Do you have any cat litter? Alright. There's gotta be a way in there through the sewer. Even if we get in, we would still need to... We would still need to make sure that we don't set off any alarms. And that could be still a problem. Okay, the crater is this way that they were talking about. These guys are just constantly dicking around these peasants. I gotta keep my eye out for some way to get into that bank, a sneaky way. This must be where the crater hit. This big divot. Here's Jess. Okay. Let's just scout the area first. Virgil's here. Powerfully built man with intense eyes and close-cropped gray hair. He's standing next to a broken fence and cursing under his breath. Now I'm gonna have to find him and bring him back. My prized bull possum, Satan. My bull possum named Satan has broken out of his pen again. Gotta find him before he tears somebody up. He wants to save Satan? Please, he's the biggest, most ornery possum you ever saw, but he's also the best damn stud in this crater. Worth his weight in gold. I gotta get him back before one of the other farmers gets hurt or guns him down in self-defense. How do we find him? If you was to find him and hurt him, I'd hurt him back this way, stranger. I'd be much obliged. Might even be able to pay you something for your troubles. You can get him moving by giving him some of these possum snacks. He loves them snacks, but if you harm or kill him, you and me are gonna have words. I got too much invest in that old possum. You have any cat litter? Oh, radiation, right? Well, I'm afraid we don't get much radiation around here. We don't hoard it. Dante might have some. He keeps cats to keep the rats away from his agave. Okay. So this is the crater where everything's being grown. Here's Jess. Let's talk to her. A sturdy young woman with dreadlocks tending to some weeds in a little vegetable patch. She looks annoyed by your presence. What do you want? We need you to switch to farm agave. Dangler sent you, didn't he? Well, I already told him. I'm not switching to agave. I certainly ain't paying for it. I'm too broke and a gal can't live on tequila alone. Look, we'd appreciate if you could grow some agave on your farm. Ha, sweet talking me ain't gonna work, stranger. You'd have to kill me to get me to switch. This town needs food, not more agave for booze. I'm the only one left making sure those folks at the clinics get a proper meal. If I stop, what happens to them? If you really want to be sweet to me, why don't you go back to Dangler and tell him I took the agave and just forget it? No, wait, that won't work, will it? What would your master Dangler say? He's gonna want 40 bullets out of you, isn't he? Are you gonna pay it? Oh, God. Can you tell me what's going on at the clinic? You haven't been over there? It's full of sick farmers, and they're only gonna get sicker if they don't get some real food. That's what I've been doing, sneaking them veggies so they don't die. And you want me to stop? Shit. We'll handle the 40 bullets, Jess. You'll pay? Wow, thank you, strangers. I didn't expect that. I don't know what I'm gonna do next time Dangler's goons come around, but you saved my ass this time. Okay. It's gonna take a while for them to get the planting going anyways. So, like, they're not gonna be able to prove it, I don't think. There's a truck down there. Oh, I was thinking maybe this pipe, but... Now it's all about finding that way into the bank, really. Okay, this is trapped. What about this one? Also trapped. Okay, we got a helmet. Some leather chaps, pocket protector, a toupee. Oops. Can we actually wear this? No. Does anybody else need pants still? Yep, Mikey does. This toupee weighs 5 pounds. Can you believe that? Whoa. Oh, here's Satan. Okay, wait. Did he give us... Oh, here's the possum snacks. Okay. Let's add this to our hotkey. Let's go and feed this thing. Yes. Now, come with me. Gives us +1 to speed. That's kind of cool. We could keep him, but... I would feel... Ooh.
Please repeat, ma'am. What's the situation again?
It's them! God's militia bastards! They got my son!
Where's
this? Where do they have your son, ma'am?
In the town square. They set up one of their tent shows down there, and they've been preaching and recruiting all day. But now they got my boy, and they say they're gonna make an example of him. They say he's a sinner.
What did he do?
Ma'am, and don't worry. We won't let your son die. Ranger Team Echo is on the way.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I love my boy.
Echo 1, this is Santa Fe Base. Come in.
Yeah, this is Echo 1. Go ahead, over.
Roger, Echo 1. Did you copy that transmission?
Yeah, we copy it.
10-4, sending you the coordinates now. And we need this handled correctly, Echo 1. This is a great chance to get another look at these gods and militia creeps. And raise our rep at the same time. Don't mess it up.
Oh, that's deep, though.
Santa Fe Base out.
Okay, what is this? Crank's attached to a rope which is hooked to a bucket. Drop the bucket in the well and turn the crank, and pretty soon you'll have some water. Oh, shit. Worm disease! Oh, God. Coordination and awareness. So it's in the water! That's what's going on here. And that's why it's only affecting the farmers, because they're the only ones down here dealing with it. And using it all the time. Oh, hello. We know what this is, don't we? Foul-smelling water. It appears to have a locked grate preventing people from climbing inside. This has got to be the way in. Okay. Let's return this guy's possum. Shit, I can't believe we have worm disease. It's just, it's plus one to speed, which is good. But I don't want to risk not having him here. Like, if we get it sick or something weird happens. Like, he's only got one health, so if he got shot, I'd feel bad. It's good to have the old bastard back. Yep. I don't have much, but take this as a reward. Hope old Satan didn't give you too much trouble. Now what can I do for you? You look like you're new to Rhodia. Okay, we got some 9mm ammo. It's our fair city, the jewel of the LA wetlands. At least it was till the damn leather jerk showed up. Now it's dying on the vine. I don't know if it'll ever come back. Old Sam the mayor brought him in for security after got attacked by the synths, but they were just taken over and dangled him from the towers. Wouldn't be so bad if they were just thugs. They get drunk, hurt some folks, and move on, but they're smart thugs. See, this here crater has a gold mine, and they're planning to strip it. What do you mean, strip it? We've all set aside a little of our land to grow agave so the mayor can make tequila at his distillery, but that bastard Dangler realized he could make a fortune if all the land was turned to agave. Now we're nothing but field slaves for a booze factory, and since nobody's growing proper food, we're all getting weak and sick besides. Okay, Virgil, what's causing the sickness? Don't know if you can blame it on Dandler and the jerks, but I will say this. We weren't getting sick when we were eating well. Yeah. Dangler's had Rhodia sussed from day one. Saw the potential here. Says he could... Saw who he could use and who he'd have to lose. Hung the mayor out to dry and took over his still. Tricked all the farmers into changing their crops. Buddied up with Gecko at the bank. And got him to make bullets the only legal tender so we could take away the ammo we need to defend ourselves. He's gonna suck on the corpse of this town until it's a bloodless husk. So you don't trust the bank then. It's not a bank, it's an ammo dump. I just know where our cash is. I don't know where our cash is. Long gone, I'd guess, but all the bullets the jerks collected at the casino and the front gate are deposited in the safe. Stolen from us so we can't use them to run those thugs out of town. What do you think about the casino? It's just another part of Dangler's master plan. The hookers, the games, the drinks, they're all meant to bleed us of our dry bullets. Or bleed us of our bullets. If we don't get rid of him and his jerks, they're gonna suck us dry. So you don't like the hookers then? Now I don't fault them, boys and girls. They're caught up in the same trap as the rest of us. Obviously Gecko's working with the jerks. He is. I didn't like that guy before the leather jerks show up. Now I hate him. Money only goes one way in that bank. And if his, it's in. Never comes out. Just you try to make a withdrawal. Never happens. How did Dangler trick the farmers? He told all us farmers he'd pay us big money to grow only agave so he could turn into tequila. Then when everybody had agreed and started planting, he told us he'd deposit all the money in our account to the bank. But now Gecko's telling us he'd put a hold on withdrawals until the unrest is over. In other words, until we're too weak to fight back. Okay, good thing we only deposited one bullet. How do you feel about the towers? Those towers were a beacon of hope in this land, and the radio I rigged to him was our connection to the outside world. Now those coyotes have made him into goddamn gun positions. So Virgil is the handyman they were talking about earlier, who hopefully can fix this. Always been handy with electronics, but those jerks smashed as soon as they showed up, more of Dangler's scheming. Could you fix this radio, Virgil? Well, I'd be happy to fix it for you, but you gotta do something for me first. You gotta save Dante Goodman, his wife Beatrice, and that rat Dangler. Oh, wait. You gotta save Dante Goodman. His wife Beatrice and that rat Dangler are trying to get him to tell her where he's hidden all his money, and once they do, they're gonna kill him. I'm still mad Dante left me for that tramp, but I don't want him to die. Oh. If you get him away from that woman, prove to him that she means him harm, then I'll fix that radio for you. But not before. And straight up killing her ain't the answer. Not before he knows, anyway. If Dante believes Beatrice died an angel, he'll mourn her for the rest of his days, and he'll never come back to... Yeah, okay, I'm selfish. I want him back, what's wrong with that? And he won't come back if he thinks I'm telling lies about her all this time. If he knows the truth, he'll come back. So show him, strangers. Show him, then I'll fix the radio. How do you want me to show him, exactly? You've got a curious idea of polite conversation. So who is this Dante? You don't know him? He owns a good fifth of the farmland in this here crater, richest farmer in Limbo Town. and I helped him get there. We were married for 20 years, ran the farm together, lived our lives together, shared a bed together. Then that hussy Beatrice came along, sniffing after his money, and it all went to hell. Dante switched teams, and I was out in the cold, just like that. Okay. So what do you think about this Beatrice, then? You know, until I met that woman, I didn't think snakes could have tits. That's pretty good. So you two were together. That's the part I don't get. Me and Dante, we love the same things. Love growing things, feeding people, tending to the possums, hard work and simple pleasures. That was us. Then this girl comes along, and she don't want none of that. Hates it. But somehow she wraps him around her little finger, and suddenly he's ashamed of all those simple, beautiful things. So he left you then. I knew Dante played both sides of the fence, and I thought he had taste. That Beatrice is about as classy as a rat sandwich and about as trustworthy as a horse pebble addict. Well, as mad as I am at Dante for dumping me, I'm worried for him too. Beatrice is only after his money, and now that she's got Dangler helping her, I don't think he's long for this world. That's why I want you to get him away from her before you make your move. I can't remember, but is Beatrice the first woman that we met that said she could lock the doors? I don't know that she is the same person there. What's horse pebble? You're lucky if you don't know. It's the drug all the kids are taking these days. Makes them into happy dreamers that ain't got enough energy to eat. Got enough energy to steal, though, at least when they need their next fix. Then they'll turn on you in a heartbeat. What do you think of the synths? A man can do what he wants to his body, replace his whole self if he wants to. I'm not gonna judge, but when you start hurting people or telling people how to live their lives, that's where I draw the line. I don't care what that Matthias says about peace and love on the radio. Those metal madmen killed friends of mine. So you're not gonna fix the radio unless we help you. When you get Dante away from Beatrice, not before. Do you have cat litter? Oh yeah, for the radiation, right? Well, I'm afraid we don't have much radiation around here, so we don't hoard it. Dante might have some. He keeps cats to keep the rats away from his agave. So Dante's gotta be in the area. I don't suppose he could come and join us now. No. Let's see how we can get to this top level here. She's still growing vegetables. I'm afraid to go back and tell that guy about this because, well, lots of reasons. Because if he calls us on our bullshit, that could ruin pretty much everything. Burned book. Let's go keep this farmer busy while we're hacking in here. Hacking in, I mean, you know. We got a human heart? What the hell? Condoms, just random stuff. Let's see. So this is a 5.56 ammo. He's getting pretty low on that. We might have to switch over to the Big Betty for a while, but the 9 mil should go to her. We got another trap, but it's also locked. Really nothing, okay. Now, I imagine that this... Well, it's going in a completely different direction, though. I wonder if this is something... Yeah, it looks like we could unlock it fairly easily. And that, but that's actually with a maxed out unlocking skill. Here, we got more possums here. Looks like this could be yet another way around. A leather jerk? What's this? This door is locked again. I hope these guys aren't close enough for this to be an issue. What do we have in here? Just a safe. Okay, it is trapped, so let's have Mikey do some work. Okay, so we got some, a little bit of ammunition. And a new shotgun that we won't really need. Mind you, it's probably better than Rose's Thorn, which we don't really use either. Yeah, it's quite a bit better. So we should maybe give this to her. 15 damage per AP. Like, that might actually be better than this thing that we're using. 28 to 35 damage. We could probably mod it a bit. Let's do like so and let's load it up. Now, this thing though, this Peacekeeper, 7 damage per AP. But I just think we have too little AP. We'd have to get into battle again for me to see it. And we would need 45 caliber ammo. Which is a very strange ammo, apparently. We have 7 available. It's this stuff here. I'm gonna actually dismantle this one. Let's make sure this is not... Yeah, okay. More broken parts. Nobody else has any of that ammo, so she's not even really able to use it. Oh, it actually already filled it. We'll give it a shot, and just to see how it works. I don't know. Like, we definitely don't have the ammo to support it. But I think it's worth a shot. Okay. We just have to check out the top level here. Where these possums are. If we can get one of those possums to follow us for the extra speed, I'll take it. Willa? Some of these have names. An older woman, clothed in rags, her face deeply carved by wind and weather, she mumbles to herself as she works. You don't look like our usual sort of jerk. Hope you're nicer than the ones we got now. Those jerks have left the poor mayor caged up in the towers for days. Don't know why they don't let him down or just kill him. Somebody should do something. Oh no, not me. I'm not a fighter. Not like my husband. But maybe you. Or you'd another bunch of jerks. That depends on who your husband is. Traveling gun salesman, Pistol Pete Peterson. Okay. He was out on a trip and I fear the worst has happened to him. No, we're good. Pete's alive. He's alive? Well, thank you, stranger. You set my heart at ease. Feel like I can breathe for the first time in weeks. Will you tell him if you see him that I'm still alive, too? Those jerks haven't killed me yet. What do you know about the jerks? Came out of the north like some kind of plague, and they promised to help, but they've only been making things worse, bringing drugs and whores and sickness, making everybody farm agave instead of wholesome vegetables and possum. So you're a possum farmer. I've been raising possums since I was younger than you, and thank the Lord for the appetites of that fat monster O'Biggin. The jerks haven't forced me to stop. He likes possum meat so much, I'm selling him a cow every 2 days. What do you think of Obigan? This could be our way to get to Obigan, actually, through this possum meat. That man ain't right in the head. Big as a house, but a mind like a child. Glad he likes my possum steaks, though. It's kept me safe where others have had terrible troubles. You don't like farming agave? Well, that's besides the point. The jerks think they are going to get rich selling tequila, so they told everyone to grow agave. Agave ain't food for eating. Only good for the still, damn fools. How are they all going to... How are all their field slaves going to work without any food in their bellies? We'll all be dead, and they'll be broke. Do you think the sickness is the jerk's fault? I don't know, but it wasn't here before they got here. My nephew's got it, and I ain't got no idea what to do about it. It's hard enough. It's enough to break a weary old heart. All I can do is pray Dr. Horshada knows what he's doing. Don't know what's wrong with his face, but there ain't nothing wrong with his mind. He's the smartest man in Rhodia. If anyone can cure us, it's him. What do you think about the towers? Those towers have been the symbol of Rhodia's hope since before the apocalypse. Now that leather jerks have turned them into some kind of Golgotha, and they smashed the radio set that used to connect us to the outside world. Well, they smashed it to trap us here, to keep us from calling for help or knowing what's happening in the rest of the world. So you don't blame the mayor for this, then? Not really, he's just a natural-born fool. He brought those jerks in protection against the metal men, and now they've taken over, poor town. It's the robot people, whatever they're called. They're a menace. Stole some possums I was selling, never getting money back. Not in a million. How come you got this one little albino possum? Poor thing, not long in this world, I'm afraid. Named him Pogo and I keep him as a pet. Sure as shooting, can't sell him. The cancer's got him and he'd poison anyone who ate him. Gives me someone to talk to though, what with my husband being away and all. Huh. Sell Pogo to us. We chop him up. We can feed him to Bigum. What? You want to buy my little Pogo for food? But I told you he's poisonous. You'd kill anybody you fed him to. Look, we want to buy him. We want Pogo steaks. Well, he's going to die soon anyways, and I can't lie and say I don't need the money. Your total's 5 bullets. Yeah, okay. You can have 5 bullets. Let's go with Chisel's bullets, since he doesn't use them anyways. Here, you can have 6 bullets, because I'm being generous. Alright, stranger, wait here and I'll have your meat for you, but don't say I didn't warn you. You eat him, it's your funeral. Come here, Pogo. Oh, no. Poor Pogo. Tainted possum steak. Okay, Leo. Be careful with that. That's actually genius, because now we can get rid of... What is this back here? Now we can get rid of that big guy, too. Oh, cat litter! Deadly. Alright, do you think we could talk to one of these? It'd be very hard. Oh shit, no! Are you serious? Yikes. I hope this doesn't set off everybody here. Alright, 1 XP. I hope she's not mad. Okay, well, taking real possum steak could actually help too, I guess, maybe. Use on self. Okay, we can actually use this. Which means it does have some value. I just can't get it mixed up with the poison possum steak. Huh. We could try another one. I just don't want to critically fail it. Nice. So now we can... Yeah, it does give the +1 speed. Beautiful. He's not going to last long, but I just wanted to get one anyways. So look, we need to find Dante. Don't know where he is. I assumed he would be out here in this area, but I haven't seen him. So I'm going to head to this pipe and see if there's a way that we can get in. We can lockpick our way in, we know that. With a small chance of failing. But we don't know where it leads. I'm hoping it leads to the bank, but it's in a strange position, so... we'll have to wait until next time to see that. Anyways, guys, wish me luck. This is probably one of the coolest areas we've had, because there's lots of intertwining stories. And I don't know how it's going to shake down, but I'm excited, so we'll see. We'll see you guys next time. Take care. Bye.